Chapter 6, Section 6, Surface Area of Cylinders. This one's a little bit more challenging than yesterday's. We're taking the information we learned yesterday and building upon it and upon another previous lesson where we found the surface area of a polyhedron. A cylinder is defined as a solid with two parallel circular bases of the same radius. My favorite cylinder is a Pringles can. I like the ranch dressing flavor the best. A cone is a solid with one circular base. I like mine to be filled with pecan praline ice cream, chocolate chip cookie dough ice cream. Another good source would be Moose Tracks. Moose Tracks is very fine ice cream to eat. And a sphere, which is a solid whose points are all the same distance from a center. A ball is a good example of a spherical shape, although a perfect sphere is just about a mathematical impossibility to create. Find the surface area of the cylinder. So we have this soda can looking thing here. It's 10 centimeters tall, 8 centimeters diameter, which means it has a 16 centimeter radius. Well, let's get that out of our way. The first thing that we have to do is we have to cut that can open and make a net of it. Just like when we were making a net of the surface area of these polyhedrons, now we're going to cut it open and make a net of the cylinder. To do that, I'm going to take my magic invisible pen here. Let me dig it out. Doop, doop. And I'm going to cut a line straight down the side, and then I'm going to cut around the top, and I'm going to cut around the bottom. Yeah, I know those were the opposite, bottom and top. And then I'm going to take this side, and I'm going to lay it out flat like a rectangle. All I did is where I cut it along here, this side is right there, this side is now right there. We unfolded the side of the can. After we do that, okay, we got indicated that there's a 10 centimeter height on that can. Then we're going to have to take and put the top and bottom on it. The top and bottom has 8 centimeter radiuses. Next thing we have to do is we need to start finding the area of the pieces parts. First thing we have to do that, though, is figure out what the base of the rectangle is. Our rectangle, if you remember, the formula for rectangle is area is equal to base times height. We have a height of 10 centimeters and an unknown base. The question is, how can we find the base? We actually have all the information we need. We just have to take and add some pieces parts to it. If you think about it, the side length, right? Let me put a better color here. Let's go for a nice magic marker. Go for blue. This side length right here is the same as the circumference of the can. The distance around the can is going to be identical to what that side length is, because when we put our can back together, this piece here is going to wrap all the way around our circle here. So in doing that, we're going to use a circumference formula. Circumference equals 2 times pi times radius, where and therefore the base of the rectangle is going to equal 2 pi radius. My pi is 3.14, my radius is 8. Plug those values in and then just start multiplying them out. You get a base of the rectangle, also known as the circumference of the circle, which is 50.24 inches, and we're going to take and write that underneath the rectangle so it's real clear what we're working with here. At this point, we have everything we need to know to start finding areas. First thing we're going to do is find the area of the rectangle. Area is equal to base times height. Area is equal to 50 × 2400 centimeters times 10 centimeters. Therefore, the area of the rectangle is 502.4 centimeters squared, which we're going to take and write real big inside the rectangle so we don't lose track of it. Next, we have to find the area of the circles, and lucky for us, the circles are the same size, so we only have to do the pi radius squared formula one time. Don't don't tell me pi r squared, pi r not squared, pi r round. I'm just saying. And in doing this, we're going to take, plug 3.1 in for our pi, 8 centimeters for our radius. Our radius squared, therefore, becomes 64 centimeters squared. Multiply that value times pi, and you get 20.96 centimeters squared for your answer of it. And that belongs to those two circles there, which if you can fit them in there, go ahead and write that in as well. Are we done? No, we're not. We found the area of each piece's part. Now we have to add them up. And adding them up, we're going to take and align the decimals. Annex zeros is needed. And then add them up. Wow, that circle sure did miss, to get 904.32 centimeters squared. Really, it's not that hard to do these. It's just a matter of going through the steps. Step one, open the can. Step two, find your base using the circumference formula. Step three, find the area of each of the pieces. And step four, add them up. Nothing to it. You pause the recording and try that one on your own. Okay, when you lay this can flat and then put its top and bottom on, it looks kind of like, I don't know, an ugly kid with big ears. Nah, cute kid with big ears. Give him a little whiskers or hair on top of his head. Maybe it's SpongeBob SquarePants with big ears. I don't know. Next, we're going to take and find the radius. The radius is going to be half of the diameter, so my radius is going to be 7 inches. Getting closer to getting the information I need. Now this time I don't need to find a base. This time I have to find the height, that spot right there. Since I need the height, we're going to take and use circumference equals pi times radius squared. Therefore, height is equal to pi times radius squared. Plug in your pi and your radius and solve for height, which is going to equal to 43.96 inches, which we're going to write over here right beside the height of our polygon. You could also put it right there on that side. It really doesn't make any difference which side it's on. Now we can start finding the areas. First thing we're going to look for is the area of the rectangle. Area of a rectangle is base times height, 18 inches times 43.96 inches, which I got here and here. And then I'm going to take and multiply those to get 791.28 inches squared, which we're going to take and write in the middle of the rectangle. You might also want to take and circle that part because it's an important piece of the problem. Next thing we're going to do is find the area of the circles. Area of a circle is pi times radius squared. The radius is not 14. No. The radius is 7. We found that earlier. 3.14 times 7 inches all squared is going to be 49 square inches times the pi value. Multiply that out, and you find the area of each circle is 153.86 inches squared. That looks like a good thing to circle as well, because that's an important part of the problem. And you can take and connect that to your two circles. From here, all that's left to do is add them up. And adding them up, we're going to take, I got them inside my circles now. We're aligning the decimals, annex zeros as needed, which we don't have to here. Add the numbers up vertically and circle your answer. Whoops, missed that circle, didn't we? Let's take and boom. Nope, need to change that. Get that out of the way. There we go. And let's go ahead and circle that answer just for kicks and giggles. Doom, boom, boom. Circle the answer. Easy math. Anybody can do this stuff. Your assignment for this lesson is going to be page 390. Looks like this is out of your new book. Numbers 3, 4, 8, 9, 11, and 13. Good luck. Thank you.
secret place.